We will continue today the discussion of yesterday. We talked about the service and different decorum of service. For example, we will discuss the dress of the Kohen and the Kohen Gadol. The regular Kohen Hedyot need to wear four different garments. The Kohen Gadol, 8. And the Kohen Hedyot, who appointed to be a Kohen Gadol, needs to go to a certain training in order to prepare himself for that. Also, we continue our discussion regards to a waving of the offering. There are certain type of offering. Some of them request a certain decorum. Part of that is the idea the Kohen places his hand under the hands of the owner, and they together wave the offering, and they bring him in, and that's part of the decorum. So there is a different view how exactly involved with that. Another important discussion, it's all these rituals that apply in the early time of the temple, is that something that we carry throughout generation, or it applies specifically to that time? So again, that's part of the discussion, and we are page 5, 10 lines from the top of the page. Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak Amar, Tnufa Ika Binayhu. We have a different view between Rabbi Yochanan and Rabbi Chanina. So Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak said the issue of waving the offering is the practical difference between the two. What? Leman de amar kol hakatuv me'akev bahem me'akva, which means the one who said that if someone failure to perform the whole specific details, that makes that work invalidate, and therefore the whole inauguration will not take place, and failure to waive this offering basically invalidates the inauguration. The other one, Leman de Amar, and the second one, which is Rabbi Chanina, that said, Davar she'ein me'akev ledorot, ein me'akev bahem lo me'akva. He said, a matter that does not invalidate offering throughout the generation does not invalidate the inauguration. So failure to waive the offering does not invalidate the inauguration. So now the Gemara elaborates on that. Uledorot menalei delo me'akva. How do you know that this act of waving, this ritual, after the fact, it's still for the future generation, is still not me'akev, it's still not invalidate the offering. The Tanya. This is in regard to a leper bringing a guilt offering. So Torah said in Leviticus chapter 14, Velakach keves echad asham litnufa lechaper alav. So he shall take one male lamb as a guilt offering, let's talk about the leper, to be waived to make atonement for him. So the Gemara asks, v'chi tnufa mechaperet? What's really atone for him? By waving the offering, that basically atone for him? V'alo en kapara el abadam. You remember yesterday we said, in order to atone, you need to sprinkle the blood on the altar. Sheneemar, the Torah said clearly in Leviticus chapter 17, ki hadam hu banefesh yechaper. The Torah said, for it is the blood that makes atonement by reason of the life. So what do you see here? The essence of the atonement, it depends upon the blood. Uma Talmud lomar litnufa lechaper. So how do you explain the Ritva said that use the word litnufa for waving to atone? So the Ritva said that it also depends upon the waving. So the Braita said she'im asa'a letnufa sharei mitzvah. So if one deemed the ritual of waving to be the centerpiece of the aspect of the mitzvah, you should remember that sharei mitzvah, it means that it's something that goes around the in act of the preparation, etc., for the mitzvah, not the mitzvah itself. So in other words, he did not waive the offering because he wasn't concerned for the mitzvah of the waving. That's, he didn't consider that as a mitzvah, and therefore he did not bother to do it. Ma'aleh alav ha-ketuv ke'ilu lo kiper. So it's like the atonement depend upon the waving. Now Rashi here tells us in the Bura Matchil Shiarei Mitzvah. So he said, Klomar, Shelo chash lachshov ota mitzvah velo samach. So Rashi here tells us that that if he does this act of smicha, he put the hands as a shiarei mitzvah, as an act of mitzvah without the full intent, so it's not considering part of that. So I explain in my book, Miracle Mar Rashi al Hashas. So Rashi said that the same is the Meiri, that he put it not as a centerpiece, but as part of that, which means if this essence of the korban, of the offering, is considering as a positive mitzvah, and that will atone for the mitzvah of smicha, and Rashi said, no, that's not atone. So the Gemara tells us here, vechiper. So the ma'aleh alav ha-ketuv kilu lo kiper, vechiper. So bediavad, after the fact, it atone, even he did not waive the offering, and therefore you have to bring another offering because the essence of the atonement depend on mainly on the blood. So therefore, ma'ale alav ha-ketuv ke'ilu. So it's like is not atone, which means after the fact there are those who say that it's accepted only bediavad, but for sure it's not mitzvah min ha-muvchar. It's not the way that we wish to. Rav Papa amar, prishat shiv'a ika benayu. So Rav Papa said that the issue of sequentering, we explained it yesterday, that you put aside. Remember that? The sequenter, the Kohen.
Sequester, yep.
Sequester. For 7 days, this is the practical difference between the opinion of Rabbi Yochanan and Rabbi Hanina. איקה בנאי, למען דאמר כל הכתוב בהם מעכב בהם מעכבה. למען דאמר דבר שאינו מעכב לדורות אינו מעכב בהם לא מעכבה. So again, the essence of this discussion is that applied to that generation only, or it's for the לדורות, for the future generation. So if you go by Rabbi Yochanan, that he said that למילואים, the inauguration, even a sequentering for 7 days, that basically me'akva, that's invalidates the inauguration, which means bediavad, after the fact. And according to Rabbi Hanina, something that it's not matter that not invalidate offering throughout the generation does not invalidate the inauguration. So in other words, if someone was failure to sequester the Kohen for 7 days, does not invalidate the inauguration. So the Gemara asks, "Uledorot menalan de lo me'akva." So how do you know that tomorrow, God willing, the Beit HaMikdash will rebuild? Amen.
And
then, the Kohen Gadol, if we do not, how do you say it, sequester here?
Sequester, yep.
Sequester here. before Yom Kippur. So that's basically cause to invalidate the entire work. So they said here, midika katan, mikra katani, because we said in the Mishnah clearly, matkinin velo katane mafrishin. We use the word, we put a matkinin, which means you put someone, you should designate another priest. And we don't say you remove another, the designate priest from his house. So it means that the second one, the second command, you don't need to go through the same process of sequestering, mm-hmm. right?
Correct.
So if something happened with the Kohen Gadol and he cannot serve, so the second one, Bediavad, is okay even if he was not sequestered.
Right.
So Tosfot HaRosh asks, how do you prove it from the Torah? So you have a problem with that. And he said that you only derive it indirectly from the Psukim. Now, would like to speak another nafkamina, another difference between Rabbi Yochanan and Rabbi Hanina, but before that, some word of introduction. There are two different decorum of clothing. One is the Kohen Hediot, the regular Kohen, and the other is the Kohen Gadol. Kohen Hediot needs to have four different clothing,
garments,
which
yeah.
garments.
Mm-hmm.
One is the ketonet, the regular clothing. Then he has to have the gartel, you know, the avnet. Mm-hmm. Then he has to have a hat and a special pants. That's four bgadim. The Kohen Gadol, it's called merubeh bgadim. He has many because he has these four that we just mentioned. And in addition, you need to have choshen, ephod, the breastplate, me'il, a special coat, and this special tzitz that carries the Kodesh LaHashem, the name of Hashem. Now, regular Kohen, Kohen Ediot, that appointed to be Kohen Gadol, he needs to go to a series of training, educating him, in order even he may be very familiar, but he still needs to go to that training in order to, in a way, sanctify himself with the sanctification of the high priest. And how that take place in a physical manner? By wearing this eight garment at that time, which is during this 7 days period before Yom Kippurim, he is wearing these extra four garments, and therefore, by doing so and putting anointing him with the oil, it's called Shemen HaMishcha, and they put it on the top of his head and between the eye, what is called eyelash, between eyelashes.
Oh, the eyebrows, right?
Eyebrows, yeah. Right, between that. So that's something that we need to do. So Ravina Amar, Ribui Shiva, Umeshicha Shiva. Ravina said that the whole concept here of the Kohen that need to do the Avodah, the service, and needs to have ribui, the many, multiple of garments, it's for 7 days, and serving with anointment for 7 days is the practical difference between the two. Ika benayu. What does that mean? Lemanda amar kol hakatuv bahen me'akev bahen me'akva. For according to one who said that if his failure to perform all the details that is written in its regard invalidates the inauguration. Failure to save with multiple garments and anointment for 7 days also invalidates the inauguration. According to one who said the matter does not invalidate offering throughout the generation, does not invalidate the inauguration, which means failure to serve with multiple garments and anointed for 7 days does not invalidate the inauguration. So the Gemara asks, "Uledorot menale de lo me'akva." How do you know in regards to the eight garments and the oil that that's something that me'akev, that invalidates, not to have an issue of invalidation of future generation? The Tanya. We learn in the Torah, in the book of Leviticus, chapter 16, in regards to work of the Day of Atonement. The Torah said, וחיפר הכהן אשר ימשך אותו ואשר ימלא את ידו לכהן תחת אביו. The Torah said, and the Kohen, who shall be anointed and who shall be consecrated to serve in his father's stead, shall make the atonement, if it's come to teach that all service must be performed by the Kohen Gadol. It is already written with regard to the Yom Kippur service that it must be performed by Aaron, the high priest, the Kohen Gadol. So lefi shenemar, shivat yamim b'sham ha-kohen tachtav, en li ela nitraba shiva v'nimshach shiva. Which means that's apply only if you have 7 days. Shnitraba v'shenimshach shiva, aval shnitraba shiva v'nimshach yom echad. Nitraba yom echad v'nimshach shiva minayim. But how do you know that if is the other way, that he have 7 days and he anointed in 8 in 1 day, or the opposite way? How do you know it? Minayin, how do you know that this Kohen Gadol, high priest, is okay to have him perform the service of Yom Kippur? Talmud lomar, asher imshach oto v'asher yemale et yado. The Torah said clearly who shall be anointed and who shall be consecrated. So meaning, mikol makom, in any case, he is appointed the Kohen Gadol, even if either appointment or donning the garment did not continue for 7 days. So the Siach Yitzchak have a girsa in Torah Kohanim, and he explains that even you have one time in Meshicha, and one time is in Ribui Bgadim, it's still mo'il, still effective. So the Gemara asked, Ashkechan ribui shiv'a lechatchila. We explained many times that in halacha we have a difference between lechatchila and bediavad. Lechatchila is the way that we wish to. So we said, we found the source that when the Kohen Gadol appointed, so you have to have multiple garments for 7 days, that should be lechatchila. Because that's the pasuk, shiv'at yamin, 7 days. The Torah said in Shmot, the 29, 7 days, Yil Beshem HaKohen Tachtav Mibana. So you derive from that, Meshicha, Shiv'a Lechatchila Menalad. So how do you know that that should be Lechatchila? So if you go by the Ravina, there is a requirement to anoint the Kohen each and every 7 day Lechatchila, even you did not do it, it's still not invalidate. But how do you know that that's applied to a future generation as well? So we said, "Bait Eima." You can say one option: "Midi itzrich kra lemiuta," because the Torah needs to exclude, which means they don't have the requirements derived from the that both donning multiple garments and anointed must be for 7 days. So anointment for 7 days is lechatchila. Another option, or another source, ve'ibay teimada. Mar Kra, the Torah said there in Shmot 29, ubigdei hakodesh asher le'aharon, yihiyu levanav acharav lemoshcha bahem ulemaleh bahem et yadam. Torah said that the garments of the Aharon, that clothing, that garment, will be also for what? For the future generation, to anoint them and to and to consecrate in them. So what do you derive? You derive here a juxtaposition. It's called Hekesh. Itkash, Meshicha leribui. We juxtapose the donning to multiple garments. How? Mar ribui shiv'a, af Meshicha shiv'a. Just as donning multiple garments is required for 7 days lechatchila, so two anointment is required for 7 days lechatchila. So now, after we explained the difference in a practical halacha between Rabbi Yochanan and Rabbi Hanina. If all of that it's invalidate or not. Now we go to the essence of that disputation. So in general, I just give you a side note that the Ritva and the Rashi and the Rambam here, the Rashi said here, Lehedia, that the requirement is to have many garments, Bishat Avodah, they have that. Rambam said that the key point is that you have eight garment, that's the main point. So, what's the reason for one who said that failure to perform the details that is written in regards to inauguration? So they said, the Torah said in regards to 7 days of inauguration in Shmot 29. Vasita le Aharon ulvanav kacha, and you shall do to Aharon and his sons according to all I have commanded you. 7 days shall you consecrate them. So what do you derive? Kacha, so it means that if you do not perform in that manner, ikuvahu, that's invalidated. So even the diavad, even after the fact, you have to do it. And not others. So the Gemara said, if you go this way, teinach kol, that you understand well. Milta dechtiva behainyana. So the Hey Amud Beit 5b says, any matter that was written in context of this topic, which is the inauguration in the Shmot, so that's invalidating the inauguration. Milta delochtiva behainyana menala. So how do you know that matter is not written in that context that invalidate the inauguration? Amar Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak Yaliv, patach patach. You derive from the verbal analogy the opening of the Ten of Meeting, and the opening of the Ten of Meeting, one is written in Exodus 29 and one is written in Leviticus 8. So it means that if someone failure to perform matters written in both portions, invalidate the inauguration. Rav Meshar, Shiamaru Shmartem et Mishmeret Hashem Ikuva. His source is Leviticus 8. The Torah said, and keep the charge of Hashem and not die, so I commend you. So they it's clear saying that if someone did not do the way that they instructed, so that invalidated the inauguration. Rav Ashiyamar, Ki Chen Tzuveiti. God said, that's the way I commanded. Which means that if someone did not perform it in the details that is written in both portions, that invalidates the inauguration. So the Ritva said here that that's applied only to that specific work that applied to a future generation. Tanu Rabbanan. So the rabbis told us. The Torah said, "For this is what I commanded you." That's what we said. Ka'asher tziveiti, as I command, which is a different source. One is Leviticus 8, one is Leviticus 10. Ka'asher tziva Hashem, that's the way God commanded, Leviticus 10, just different pasuk. Kichen tziveiti, now we elaborate in each pasuk. The first one, apply be'aninut yochluha. Which means that if Aharon and his sons are onanim, you remember the story in the Torah, for example, that Aharon lost his two sons and the other two sons lost the two brothers. So that day that Nadav and Avihu passed, the fire came from heaven and consumed them, the Torah said, right? So they cannot eat a consecrated item while they are onanim. Onanim, remember that's a period of time between the passing and burial. But Moshe told them anyway to eat the mincha, and therefore he used the term kichen tzuveiti, that's the way I was commanded. Hmm. Which means God told them at that time that they should eat it. And he said in regards to sin offering, ka'asher tziveiti bishat ma'aseh amar lahem. When Moses heard that they burn that sin offering, and he rebuked them that they should not burn it. So he told them that you should eat it the way that I commanded you in the mincha offering, because I was commanded by Hashem that you should eat that consecrated item, even you are in a state of onanim. That's the way Rashi explained to us. In that matter, Moses said that this was the Seir Rosh Chodesh, that's the Korban, and not the Seir for the 8 day of inauguration. So, therefore, you need to say Kasher Tziva Hashem, as God commanded, Ve'lo me'en lai ani omer, which means I'm not the one who initiated that. So, therefore, you should do it the same that you did in a sin offering, and not the way that you did in a peace offering, because in a sin offering you burn it. So that's the way Rashi said. Now we go back to the whole concept of 7 days of inauguration. Amar Rabbi Yossi Bar Chanina, Michnasayim, he says that the pants, that's one of the garments, priestly garment, Ein Ktuvim BaParasha, it is not written in the concept of the inauguration, which means it is not written clearly, unequivocally, that when the Kohanim wore these garments, which is, one is the Parashat HaTzava'a, and one is called Parashat HaAsiya, which means that these two different times the Torah mentioned the text of the inauguration, but it's only alluded indirectly from the text. Why? Because they said Kshehu Omer, and the Torah said in Shemot in Exodus 29, Veze Adavar Asher Ta'ase Lahem Lekadesh Otam Lechahen. So we derive from the letter Vav in the word Veze that's in addition. You know that every single letter in the Torah carries a meaning. So that we juxtapose the point of the portion of the inauguration to something that we said early in the Torah, which is the preparing of the priestly garment. Lehavi hamichnasayim, because they said the other one in Leviticus 20, in Exodus 29, 28, michnasei bad, you shall make for them a pants, vaasirit ha'efa, and the tenth of an eifah. So what do we derive from that? So you derive that each and every Kohen needs to bring the day that he start his avodah, his special holy work, he needs to bring the first time tenth of eifah, which called minchat chinuch. It's like special offering for that day that he was appointed, also in each and every day that he is the Kohen Gadol, Minchat Chavitin, and the Kohen Idiot bring it only on the first day. That's Rashi tells us based on the Gemara in Menachot 51. So he said this type of offering was brought during the 7 days of Miluim. And even it wasn't written clearly in that part, we derive it from the word Veze Hadavar. So the Gemara asked, Bishlama Michnasayim Ktivei Binyan Adiv Gadim. We understand when it's come to wearing that garments, so it's written in the list of preparation of certain clothing in the parasha, the portion that preceding the inauguration, and we derive from the word, from the letter Vav, additional Vav, that's in addition, he needs to have. Ela asirita efa menalan. How do you know that the tenth of efa he needs to bring in those days of inauguration? So we now said Atya ze. Ze korban Aaron uvanav asher hakrivu la'Hashem asirit ha'efa. We use a juxtaposition from the two times using the word Ze, meaning this. This is the offering of Aharon and his sons, which they shall offer to God in the day that they that he is anointed, a tenth of ephah. So you see clearly that that's applied to what to the two times that it's applied also the day of inauguration. We learn another important point for those days of inauguration. Amar Rabbi Yochanan, Mishum Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai, Minayin she'af nikra parasha me'akev. Moses, Moshe Rabbeinu, called before the children of Israel this special portion that it's called Tzava'at Hamilu'im, which means that inauguration. All the rules of the inauguration, and he did it on the first day, so the which was 23rd day of the month of Adar, which is the first day of the Miluim. He gathered together all the people to the tent of meeting, and he commanded them. So they said, Me'akev, how do you know that if he didn't do it, that basically invalidate the world. So the Gvuratari said that even just citing that, lack of citing that invalidated it. Talmud Lomar, we derive from Vayikra in Leviticus 8, Vayomer Moshe Laida, Moses said to the congregation, Ze hadavar asher tziva Hashem, afilu dibur me'akev. He said, this matter, davar, that God has commanded to be done, that even failure to perform the recitation, the dibur of the Torah portion to the people, invalidates the inauguration. Next part, we discuss the idea of wearing these garments, how that process took place. So they said, Keitzad ilbisham, how, which means in what order Moshe Rabbeinu dressed the Aharon and his sons, that priestly garment in those days of inauguration. So they said, Kitzad il bishan, mande hava. What it was. Why are you asking this question? So, the Gemara said, Ela, Kitzad malvishan latid lavo, which means we are not speaking here about past, we're talking about Mitzvah Shem when the Beit HaMikdash will rebuild. So, when we have this time of Tchiyat HaMetim, right, and then you have the time that Aaron and his sons would dress with the priestly garment, so they said that the time of Tchiyat HaMetim, they need to sanctify again Aaron and his sons in the sanctification of the priesthood, because by passing the original anointment is already abrogated, you need to make a new one. So the Ramban in Sefer HaMitzvot, Shoresh Gimel, and also the Chazon Ish, or Rachaim, Kuf Kavav, both of them said that they need to have a new inauguration. So he said, in which order they will be dressed. So the Gemara asked, so in other words, that's the reason why we ask, we want to know the order. So he said, "La'atid lavon nami, lechshavo Aaron uvanav Moshe imahem." So what's the problem? When we have the time of Tchiyat HaMeitim, so what, guess what happened? Aaron and his sons will come, and Moshe Rabbeinu also will join him with them. So if you have a question, you can ask. So what's the problem? So he said, Ela keitzad hilbishan, that's original question, how it was in those days of inauguration. And even what happened, we need to understand le misbar krai. We need to understand it in order to explain the verses on this topic, as they appear somewhat contradictory. How? Now you see. Plige bab ne Rabbi Chia ve Rabbi Yochanan. Chad amar, one said, Aaron v'achagach banav. First, Aaron take precedence, and then his sons. V'chad amar, Aaron uvanav bevat achat. The same time. So Abaye elaborated on that disputation. Amar Abaye, bichtonet u'mitznefet, which means in regards to the tunic and the mitre. Everyone agrees that Moshe Rabbeinu addressed Aaron and afterward his sons. Kula amalo pligid Aaron b'chakach banav. The bein betzavahu ben basiyahu kadim. That both they in the implementation mentioned that Aaron proceed to his sons. Ki pligay, the question is be'avnet, when it's come to the belt, the girdle. Man da amar Aaron b'chakach banav. One they said at Aaron and then his sons, they said it grinded him with the bell. That's Leviticus 8. And then it's written, and he grinded them with a belt. And one said that they're all together at the same time. Because it's written, and you should grind them with belt, Aaron and his son. And one who said that Aaron and his sons at the same time, like simultaneously, they said that he girded him with belt, and right away it's written, and he girded them with belt. So what do you see here? That he said that he dressed Aaron and his sons, so that which means that Aaron proceeding to wear the belt before the sons. Amar lach, so the Gemara answers that he could have said to you, Hahu avneto shel kohen gadol, lo zehu avneto shel kohen ediot. So he said that the belt that he used for the kohen gadol is not the belt of using for the Kohen Gadol. So I explain in my book, Birei Klomar, Berashi Al Hashas, I elaborate on this Rashi, because there is a Rashi here. Rashi said, at the top of the page 6, Klomar leolam kra de tzava'a bevat achat. So that's Rashi, it basically also, you see it in the Tosfot, in Tosfot Arosh, that the garments, the belt is not the same. So here there is two times that they basically have this wearing the girdle, the belt. One is that just the time that they wear it before, and the other one it's the real difference doing the work. So in general what we understand is you have to see the whole explanation, the whole mahalach. But they say that the way that they made them, it's also different. If you go sometimes to the Hasidic Rebbe's, you see that the Rebbe has a different belt than the others. You see they have a certain one. But anyway, here that Rashi used the term Shlamdenu ba shena avnetim shavim, that those belts are not the same. That the belt of the high priest, the Aaron, it wasn't the same as his sons, that the regular Kohen Ediot. His belt was made of pishtan, of what is called linen, right? Wool. And the other one, and it's also carry tolat shani v'tzemer, which is a wool and linen. And the belt of his sons, they made only wool, I think, and not linen, like all the other garments of the regular priests. And it's a famous question how the Kohen Gadol dress something that combine wool and linen. It's not an issue of Shabnez. We know that question, and we answered several times. But in this way, the Torah implies indirectly that there's a difference between the two belts, in these two psukim, and that's, I think, what Rashi meant here also. Uleman be'amar. So now we ask, according to the second opinion, Aaron v'achagach banav. It was first Aaron and then his sons. Ve'aktiv v'chagarta otam avnet Aaron uvanav. The Torah said, and you will gird them with belt, indicate that they were girded simultaneously. So he said, Amar lach, hahu, kamashman avneto shel kohen gadol, zehu avneto shel kohen ediot. Over there, it means that they are identical, both belt. And he said, and the way that they wear these garments, vayachgor oto avnet. So the Torah said, and girded him with a belt. And it's written there, vayachgor otam, and he girded them. So lamali, why the Torah did not incorporate them in one pasuk? Shma mina aharon ve'achar kach banav, which means it's not the style of the belt, it's the procedure, the order. So the one who said that they do it together, ubevat achat mimashkachat lei, how do you find that they are on his sons, does that simultaneously? Is that possible that that Moshe Rabbeinu put the garments for five people at the same time? So the Gemara said, Lo tzricha. It doesn't mean that he does that in one time. The akdim, you have to say that it's necessary only to state that Moshe girded Aharon first and then proceed to gird his sons in order of their significance. And after girding Aaron, he did not dress Aaron in any other garment before girding his sons. So this is a different opinion between Ritva and Meiri, and it's all based of what Rashi meant when he used the word Bevat Achat, how that exactly happened. Let's go to a practical halachot. Rambam, Sefer Avodah, Hilchot Maaseh HaKorbanot, Chapter 3. Question is, if smicha me'akevet or ena me'akevet, if placing the hands of the offering, it's a must or not. So they said, although the one bringing an offering is obligated to place his hand on the offering, if he fails to do so, the offering is still valid and effect atonement. Nevertheless, it is considered as though the individual did not achieve optimal atonement. So again, it's a gradation, it's a different level of kapara, of atonement, so it's not considering that the one achieved the maximum. We also, Rambam, Hilchot Klei HaMikdash, Chapter 1, after the Kohen Gadol is appointed, he is anointed with anointing oil and dressed in the 8 priestly vestment. In the absence of anointing oil, the priestly vestment suffices to consecrate him. Now we also talk about Ribui Shiva. That's Rambam Elchot Klei HaMikdash, chapter 4. A Kohen Gadol is consecrated by donning and then removing the 8 garments of each of the 7 days. When there is anointing oil in the Beit HaMikdash, he is also anointed on each of the 7 days. Now, the last halacha is the Asirit Ha'efa. A Kohen begins his service in Beit HaMikdash, and the Kohen Gadol begins each day of his service there by sacrificing a meal offering of 1/10 of an Ha'efa from his own fund. And that's the Rambam Hilchot Klei HaMikdash, Chapter 5, and Kesef Mishneh. But as we explained, that's called Minchat Chinuch. It's like the Chinuch is education, but it means that it's like the point of beginning, the point of departure. That was the special offering. It has to be from his own pocket.
Tzahaveh.